Hey everybody, the Metalocalypse here, and welcome to the first ever Monday Night Mugen. This was recorded on September 10th of 2012, and it'll hopefully be a long and prosperous series like my random Mugen Battle series, so let's go ahead and move on. I'll kind of cover some basic stipulations about Monday Night Mugen. Like I said, it's a new series featuring Mugen Battles of my choosing. It's a separate entity from my main request-based series. So that basically means it's a standalone. All the records, wins, losses, and stuff stay over here. It's completely separate from the request-based series. And anyhow, moving on to how this is going to work. For the first 10 weeks of Monday Night Mugen, I'm going to use it to determine a win-loss percentage for all of the 35 characters I've selected to be on the inaugural roster here. And at Monday Night Mugen episode 11, that's when I will unveil our ratings tier system and also the championships that'll be I'm going to have characters defend, which will be like my high profile main event matches and such, and the stipulations required for battling those championships. So with that being said, I'll go ahead and transition over to my Mugen engine and unveil the roster for everybody. And then we'll go ahead and transition back up here and we'll take a look at tonight's card before moving on to our first contest. So I will be right back with that roster. Alright, now that the roster has been unveiled, we'll take a look at tonight's card. So our opening contest will feature Goat taking on The Flash. The second matchup will feature our lovely ladies division, which will be every character I have that's a female character. Morrigan, BloodRayne, Rouge the Bat, and Highway Star teaming up against Wonder Woman, Hatsune, Miku, Yoko, Ritona, and Blossom. In the third matchup, we have a tag team contest featuring CM Punk and Psychopath Kyo taking on the fast food tycoons of Ronald McDonald and Colonel Sanders. In our fourth match, we have a clash of the giants as Bowser takes on the Incredible Hulk, I should say. And then we move on to the main event of the evening, which will consist of the Dancing Banana, King Kong, Evil Ryu, and Marvin the Martian taking on Mario, Ness, and Kirby, and Kratos. So with that being said, I'll go ahead and send it down to the first matchup of the evening. And thank you for watching Monday Night Mugen. It is time for the opening contest here on Monday Night Mugen. We're having Go take on Flash here, so let's go ahead and start this one up on top of New York, which is the USA ring stage here, which I'll refer to it from now on. Fighting in New York City, I guess, here. Well, Goat, looking forward to debuting here in Monday Night Mugen. It's a pretty formidable foe in the Flash. However, right now, Goat was getting the moves off there, and now slight retaliation here from the Flash. Pretty balanced here. Looks like Goat opening up a pretty big lead here. Will Flash fight back, getting in and out there. Hit a couple of punches, but Flash hanging on there by a thread of his life. A little tornado barrage there. Flash with a stroke of moves, but Goat gets the killing blow in round one. Well, how about that, Goat? Let's see if you can finish off the Flash here. And we start off much the same. Flash not putting on a very impressive showing here at all in round two. Well, he tried to use an ultimate there, but looks like Goat countered. Finally, Flash calling out somebody there to help him. He was gone in a flash, and it didn't do nothing to Goat. Goat hanging on here pretty well. Finally, Flash get a little bit of offense in there. Left Goat hanging in the air for a second. And now Goat with that big sword uppercut and that down slash, and down goes the Flash. And Goat is victorious here in the opening contest on Monday Night Mugen. And as stated, wins and losses aren't going to really affect our contestants, or our combatants, I should say, until about week 10. And then that's when the championships and such in our A and B and such tiers will be set. So with all that being said, let's go ahead and briefly transition here, and our second match will be taking place. It's time for our second matchup here on Monday Night Mugen. And tonight we have a 4-vs-4 lovely ladies match featuring a team consisting of Morrigan, BloodRayne, Rouge the Bat, and Highway Star going against Wonder Woman, Hatsune, Miku, Yoko, Ritona, and Blossom. And of course, this will be all 8 of the female characters I have featured on my roster, and hopefully they'll all get a chance to battle here. Well, let's get this battle underway. And maybe one team will pick up a huge advantage, and we'll start picking up some wins and losses here nonetheless. And, well, starting off Morrigan doing well. Got the first move on Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman not happy about that. Retaliates here. Well, Morrigan looked impressive at the start, now kind of falters out. Wonder Woman using that golden lasso, trying to finish Morrigan off quickly here. Wow. Wonder Woman just barraging Morrigan there, but it didn't do nothing. Morrigan has her wings up, pretty defensive right now, but it looks like Morrigan in trouble. She retaliates her a little bit, trying to hang on. Warrior toss there from Wonder Woman. Transform into the Valkyrie. It's Valkyrie versus Vampire here, and it looks like Wonder Woman takes out Morrigan. Well, Morrigan's team technically not out of it yet. Someone on there could pull the gauntlet upset. Maybe it'll be BloodRayne. Well, Wonder Woman starting off dominating BloodRayne here. BloodRayne looks like they're not even able to do anything here. Cornered there. And slowly but surely, it looks like this one about over. I think Wonder Woman has this one wrapped up, folks. Does BloodRayne have anything left in the tank? I don't think so. Just corner there. Down goes BloodRayne just like that. And Wonder Woman, 2-for-2 here. Doing well for her team, as any captain should do. Well, there's the invisible jet there. Will Rouge the Bat do anything? Here, let's find out. So far, Wonder Woman looking like she may have a stranglehold here on the lovely ladies division here of Monday Night Mugen. She's dominated her first 3 opponents here, and I don't think the computer's going to be able to mash the button fast enough to get out of that. And it doesn't look like it is Rouge and pummeled here. Maybe she'll be able to get some sort of offense out there. Somehow Rouge, wow, a little tornado whirl there. And suddenly, this one a little interesting here. Rouge showing us something here we haven't seen since round 1. Well, again, that Valkyrie attack there is brutal here on Rouge. And taking a lot of damage. Rouge finally counterattacked there, but it may be too late, folks. Wow. Wonder Woman just putting the moves to Rouge just like that. A golden axe, and down goes Rouge the Bat. Well, it's down to Highway Star for her team. Will she be able to run an ace? It's highly unlikely here. I've seen crazier things, though. Let's see. Starting off, wow. Highway Star super aggressive here, and Wonder Woman just getting dominated here after what looked like a stranglehold on this match. Suddenly, Highway Star coming out. Looks like she means business. Wonder Woman not even able to get out of the gates in this one, folks. Finally, Wonder Woman trying to mount some sort of offense. Looks like she got overwhelmed here, maybe perhaps overlooking Highway Star here or something. Well, anyhow, it costs her dearly as down goes Wonder Woman, and Highway Star keeping her team alive. Well, up next, oh boy, it's the loading screen of doom as Hatsune Miku coming in here. Uh-oh. Let's see what's going to happen. Eventually, we will have this one loading up here, folks. Hopefully, she'll be coming out eventually, like I say. We can play the Jeopardy waiting theme here or something, but I don't think I'm going to have the copyright privileges for that one, unfortunately, here. Trust me, nonetheless, this match will get started here eventually. Oh, I can guarantee you I have to talk. I'm buying time here, folks. There we go. My screen flickers. I see Hatsune Miku coming out. The 300 megabyte character. apparently takes forever to load. And wow, Highway Star getting dominated here by Miku. And Highway Star finally mounts some offense, a little toss into a barrage of kicks, and Highway Star challenged here to the max by Hatsune Miku. Well, it looks like Highway Star putting the moves there to Miku. That's a pretty even matchup here. It looks like Highway Star got her kind of trapped in a cheap combo here. Uh-oh. Miku trying to sing Highway Star to death here. Well, it looks like somehow Highway Star survived that one. But I don't know if she's going to survive the encore presentation. Well, somehow she tosses her there, gets this barrage of kicks. Highway Star in a fight for her lives, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like Miku's starting to flutter out here. Does she have anything left here? Trying to get her off with those little single note attacks. And now comes out. Who the heck knows? Some sort of giant thing. And Highway Star trying to survive here as my voice starts to fade already, ladies and gentlemen. Uh-oh. Well, down goes Hatsune Miku. Just like that, Highway Star hanging on by a thread. She could bounce back here. Yoko, not the toughest of female fighters here. Let's see if she can hold her own. No, Highway Star, super aggressive. Seeing her chance at a mismatch here in an opponent, I guess. Yoko clearly not prepared for Highway Star there. Somehow she does mount a little offense. Highway Star, however, just too much for Yoko. Ritona uses that and to basically restore some of her health, because she'll be in for a challenge here, ladies and gentlemen. Is up next, it's Blossom, who even is taking a moment to load there. Apparently my computer not very tolerant of the Mugen engine sometimes, so I'm just kidding here. Well, so far Blossom was starting off perfect there. However, Highway Star retaliating, getting back in there, she got stuttered in that ice. And Blossom using an ultimate Blossom punch there. Only connected a couple of times though. Highway Star looking for some sort of way out of this here. Counters, gets Blossom down, and Blossom in trouble now. Got hit in that little loop of attacks that Highway Star is known to do. Ooh, getting glitched in that ice there again. Looking hilarious why it happens. A thunderclap there from Blossom, and what's going to happen? Does Highway Star have anything left? This one pretty competitive, folks. Showing off the finest of the lovely ladies division here. Highway Star doing her best to hang on. Has a fraction of life, gets frozen there. Uh-oh, looks like Blossom is getting the icy chiltastic of doom there, or the chalktastic. I have been out of Mugen for a while there, like I say. Well, let's see, we have Blossom getting the win for her team here as, well, the lovely ladies put on an impressive showing here in our second matchup of Monday Night Mugen. And what does Blossom have to say? Life is good, ha 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 ha. Like the Mandark laugh? Ha 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 ha. Never mind. We're not even going to go there, ladies and gentlemen. But we are going to be going to our third matchup here at Monday Night Mugen, which will be coming up right after a little... And we're moving right along here, ladies and gentlemen, on to our third matchup, which is a tag team contest featuring CM Punk and his partner, Psychopath Keo, taking on the fast food tycoons of Ronald McDonald and the Colonel of KFC, Colonel Sanders himself. Well, let's get this battle going here. Let's see, we'll come out victorious in our first official tag team contest here. Is the Colonel wearing the green duds there? And CM Punk, tribute to Bret Hart, apparently, as he's going with the pink lineup here. And so far, Punk and Keo doing well as a team here. Straight edge superstar and the psychotic superstar working well as a team here. As fast food tycoon's trying to come back. Ronald with the big uppercut there, and Colonel Sanders. Uh-oh. Suddenly the Punk and Psychopath team are in big trouble here. Who's going to bounce back? I don't know if... well, down goes Punk there. I think we know who's winning this first round here. I don't think Keo can take out both the fast food tycoons by himself. No, he cannot. He's getting the old whammy attack here from Colonel Sanders. Just a barrage of strikes there from his old sword cane. And that pretty much sums it up there. Keo blowing up with anger. And Punk laid out as well. Let's see if Punk and Keo can bounce back here, ladies and gentlemen. Starting off a little bit better here for him as they somehow cornered Ronald there, but Colonel getting in there, just taking out both Keo and Punk by himself. Because now the Colonel focuses on Keo there, where Ronald is doing his best impersonation of making CM Punk into a punching bag there. And now we see the French fry and the hamburger barrage there, and a barrage of strikes from the Colonel as well. And Punk and Keo in big trouble here now that they've got Ronald and the Colonel have got him separated here. Our fast food tycoons finally getting hit with a big move there from Psychopath Keo, showing his stuff, trying to fight for his life now, ladies and gentlemen. As Ronald using that finger fry to destroy CM Punk and Colonel Sanders with the big cane strike, taking out Psychopath Keo. And well, that was a finger-looking good battle there, ladies and gentlemen. Well, after a brief little transition, we'll move on, I should say, to our fourth matchup here tonight at Monday Night Mugen. And it's time for our fourth matchup of the evening, and we have a one-on-one contest of a couple of giant green hulking monsters here, and one of them happens to be the Hulk, and the other one happens to be Bowser, so let's get this contest started up. Man, who writes these lines for me? I hope nobody, man. I should fire my writer. Just kidding. Well, let's see. Is Bowser coming out here? And, well, Hulk apparently in Bowser's mouth to start things off. But Bowser taking the first couple of attacks here as Hulk's starting to dominate here. Bowser finally with a claw swipe retaliates here. But Hulk cornering Bowser. And Hulk using that big rain of boulders there and tearing the ground up. Bowser getting overwhelmed here in round one. I thought he'd put up a better fight there as his claws getting absorbed. The Hulk showing that he is no pushover, ladies and gentlemen. Another ground smash, and Bowser trying to use an upside down shell spin. And Bowser unleashing a mini flame breath there. And evens this one right up. Another claw swipe. It was looking very impressive there from the Hulk at the start. He's kind of fluttered out there, but he's almost finished Bowser off now, and he did it, ladies and gentlemen. Hulk getting what I would say pretty much is an upset there in round one. Let's see if he's going to score the complete upset here, or Bowser's going to bounce back. Another big boulder smash there from the incredible Hulk. He can call it what it will, but we're calling it the boulder smash, as well. Bowser overhead toss, and wow, he's starting to finish the Hulk off here. And this one all even, ladies and gentlemen. Bowser very angry after losing round one. So this one coming down to the third round. Three. Pretty competitive matchup after all here. And Bowser, let's see if he's going to maintain the momentum, or if Hulk's going to come back and do like he did in round one. Bowser going to the cheap breath attacks here. Keeping to the range. Notice that he was getting pwned when he was getting up close to Bowser. So Hulk finally launches cheap attacks. Bowser seeing through it. Big shell spin, and that's it. Hulk, after an impressive first round, goes down. And Bowser, impressive in his debut, ladies and gentlemen. Well, that was the last of our lower end, our lower card matches. Up next is the main event of the evening. So stay tuned, and it's time for our main event of the evening, and tonight I have a couple of 4v4 teams here for y'all. One consisting of Dancing Banana, King Kong, Evil Ryu, and Marvin the Martian. The other consisting of Mario, Ness, Kirby, and Kratos. Let's get this battle started up, ladies and gentlemen. The inaugural main event of Monday Night Mugen is underway. There's Mario in the super suit here, and peanut butter jelly time is also underway here, apparently. Wow, the Dancing Banana is super aggressive here. Starts off by cornering Mario. Mario finally mounting some offense, tosses Banana into the corner here. Banana using his bowling ball tackle attack. And he missed blindly with a back kick there. Mario makes him pay for it with the raining coins uppercut, we're going to call that one. He's making it rain as Dancing Banana is making it rain with the dance moves, I guess. And Banana slowly but surely, or I should say, finishes off Mario nonetheless. Down went Super Mario. Dancing Banana just He's moving too fast for me to even commentate him here. Well, let's see if he can continue the trend here and take out Ness. Oh, Ness using the cheap kick attack here? Oh boy, that's it. I don't think Dance Banana's getting out of this one. Apparently, Ness studied up and reverted to the attacks the little kids would use at, like, the arcades back in the day when I used to go there. Nonetheless, I don't want to relive any more of those nightmares. Let's see if King Kong can avenge his tag team partner. Uh-oh. King Kong somehow rolled out of the way of most of that, PK Starstorm. Saw it coming, scouted Ness very well until that, flame barrage or hit him, and King Kong retaliated there with some left hands. He slammed the ground, forcing Ness to use up all his defense. Uh-oh. Ness is gonna get stunned. Every time that defense gets broke, I think, doesn't he take a little damage? Well, King Kong making sure he takes damage there with that up or that left hook again. And King Kong slowly but surely, another left hook. This one, even as it gets here, King Kong resorting to that ground pound, doesn't want nothing to do with Ness, keeping him at a distance, trying to finish him off with some right-hand forearm smashes. Ness trips him up there with that yo-yo, but King Kong using himself as a bowling ball to take out Ness and avenge his tag team partner. Let's see if he can continue this avenging, I guess, match or spirit here as he goes against Kirby. Kirby, definitely a main event contender here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see, King Kong definitely has his work cut out for him here, as it looks like, Well, Kirby just walking up to him and cutting him into a million pieces there. It's Reigning Ape. Hallelujah, Reigning Ape. Never mind, we're not even gonna go there. Oh, and it's a fatality. Up next, it's Evil Ryu coming out. Is he gonna be any match for Kirby here? Evil Ryu, one of the tougher competitors we have here in singles competition. So Kirby in for a fight. As we can see, Kirby getting beat here early on. Does Evil Ryu have enough to stop Kirby? Kirby using that 100-ton smash, I should say. But Evil Ryu counters, has Kirby in a corner, has him in the pickle right now. Is Kirby going to be able to get out of this? Tries to roll out. Ooh, Evil Ryu misses what would have been a sure finishing blow there, and Kirby making him pay for it, trying to fight back, a big shuriken uppercut there, and there it is. Evil Ryu taking out Kirby. It's down to Kratos. Is he going to be able to avenge his partner there? Kratos unleashing the fury of a god there. Is, well, Evil Ryu unable to get close to Kratos right now. Kratos has him in the corner. And Kratos, the god character himself here, the son of a god, doing massive damage to Evil Ryu. And that's it. Or I should say, the god of war. Well, let's see if the god of war is able to take on the, or take out the Martian invader here. The brains behind his team here. Well, Marvin starting off, it was pretty impressive here, but now getting, he's holding his own so far. Until that big blue tornado wave hit him, and now Marvin just getting cornered. I don't know how Marvin thinks he's going to do anything. Uh-oh. He's getting finished off here. Yep. Torn into, and somehow Marvin's skeleton expanded there when he got broken in half. But Kratos getting the win for his team here, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I certainly hope everybody enjoyed our first ever Monday Night Mugen. And I will have a Monday Night Mugen episode 2 up, of course, next week. We'll feature probably the rest of the roster that didn't get a match in the first week's show here. And I'm sure we'll have other surprises in store. Who knows what else I can think of here. Is that, well, we've seen some people get a win, start off on a hot streak, and others not so much. I hope everybody enjoyed Monday Night Mugen. Thanks for watching.